What's up, everybody? Pile 702 back today with a RSA review. So, VandyVape, VapeHappy, Capstone RDA. It's really an RSA. Made by VandyVape, designed by VapeHappy, which is an online distributor. They're actually based out of the 702, Las Vegas. So I personally know the guys over there. I ordered like a lot of my juice and a lot of my cotton and stuff, and you can actually go pick it up in person. So I've got to know a lot of the guys that work over there. And they asked me if I would like to review this, and I said, hell motherfucking yeah, I'd like to review this. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna go downtown. I'm gonna show you all around the Capstone RSA. We're gonna throw a build in it. Got something really nice for you to listen to. After that, we're gonna pop back up. Pros, cons. You know how we do it. VandyVape Capstone RDA by VapeHappy. You can see that this is a very different presentation than most VandyVape products. Actually, very, very nice. You can see you get two caps. There's your deck right there. But before we get into all that, let's have a pause on the back for the stat sheet. And pause. All right, and we good? On the side, you have your scratch and sniff. You have the dealio that you put your phone on and scan, and then it links you right up to it. You can see I have the gold rendition right there. Bottom says VandyVape. Address to China and all that good stuff, but I don't go to China. I just go right down the street to Las Vegas where VapeHappy is. Upon opening your capstone from VapeHappy, you will see that you have a plethora of goodies in here. But we're gonna start with the boring stuff on bottom first, and then we'll get back to this. You will get one VandyVape instruction pamphlet that is, you know, the size of a tent. I wouldn't recommend reading it. I mean, who reads anymore? Anyways, it's for the birds. Just watch this review. You get your little VandyVape looking dude that says it passed quality control. I forget what his name is. I thought this dude had a name, but he just looks kind of like an eraser head or some shit like that. But that's your QC. You get a bag of goodies, which consists of a tri-tool, a ass load of O-rings. You get an extra, you get a solid 510 if you don't want to squonk this. I don't know why you wouldn't want to squonk this. It's a complete squonking RDA, RSA. Extra spring for the system. It only has one screw for the entire deck, and it's spring loaded. I'm gonna explain it all to you in a minute. And that's pretty much it on that. Also you get some coils. But not only do you get coils, they went above and beyond. They tell you what you got. You got fuse Clapton coils, 26 on the inner with 35 on the wrap. It tells you the material. So you have NI80. Nichrome 80, and this should ohm out to 0.28, six wraps, and it even gives you the inner diameter, which is 3 millimeters. So please, a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for a company and an RDA that gives you a coil and tells you what it's made of, what it ohms out to, and everything else. Please, give it up. Thank you. You're far too kind. Okay, a little bit more. A little bit more. Thank you. Okay, we're good. We're good. Stop. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. You will also get a knockoff of the coily tool, which was designed by a British guy named Simon. It looks like a VandyVape kind of, I mean, let's just be honest. VandyVape just kind of jacked his invention. I actually have the coily tool, and I will be using it in some reviews because they sent it to me, and it's a lot better than this, but it's similar. This right here is telling you that for this RSA, you would use number 7, and you would just drop your coil in there and then trim the legs on the back. I don't use this thing, but if you're new to installing, like, you know, if you just got out of sub-ohm tanks and you're doing rebuildable drippers and stuff like that, something like this is actually very helpful instead of, you know, clipping stuff too short, whatever, wasting coils. So kind of nice, but I'll give the credit to Simon from the coily tool. You also get this very nice dock style knurled 810 drip tip. It's not an actual dock drip tip, but it looks just like one. This is your 810. Very, very nice. Top cap. I chose the gold one right here. It comes in, you have a gold stainless steel, matte black, or like the rainbow looking one. Those are your options. I went with gold just because I have a shitload of mods that are Ultim, brass, stuff like that. And I just like gold in general. The drip tip that comes on top of your metal cap, it's gonna be like a 510. You see how it funnels down. It's actually two different pieces. So this is Delrin. This will pop off if you wanna put the 810 on, but you can also use your own 510s if you don't like this one right here, which you can see is very, very restrictive. It's gonna help on the flavor, but you know, if you're a cloud chaser or something like that, that's not gonna cut it for you. Now the airflow system on this, I happen to really enjoy. There's a single coil option. I don't know why you would run this in single coil, but there is a single coil option. But the way that this AFC works, as you can see as I turn it, it splits in half your airflow. So instead of closing it off completely, it just cuts it in half. Now, some people view this as a con. I think this is actually a brilliant way to do it, because when you are constantly closing, if you're closing this off halfway, you have now put your airflow not on the center of your coil. Now this cap is machined with the notches in it that lines it up, which means if this did close from side to side, there would be no way for you to spin this cap to aim whatever airflow is open to the center of your coil. So the fact that this closes down halfway, to me, is a massive pro. Let me just wind that back. So that's all the way open. As you can see, you just turn it, and it cuts your airflow in half, but it keeps it straight across like that. So you're going to still get maximum airflow to the center of your coil instead of the side. So I rather enjoy the way that they did this. If you pop it off and you look at this top cap, you will see the nice conical design. You get a little domed up on it. Everybody loves to get domed up. Got some dumbage for the flavor. Very, very nice. And then inside the barrel, machining, very nice. Very smooth. There's no like discoloration or inconsistencies or anything like that. So very nice, very well done. tolerances, very nice. It's like a, I don't know, it reminds me of like a fucking disco ball or something like that. Now, this is a nice cap, but this isn't the cap that I use with it. The cap that I use with it, it comes with a clear plastic cap. Now, this clear plastic cap, there is no adjustment to the airflow. It's just like this, this kind of trapezoid looking airflow on both sides. And it's just wide open. Now, that's not a huge amount of airflow. It's actually perfect. With the top right here, the diameter on this guy. So you're looking at a little over 9 millimeters for the inside of this. Yep, about, I'd say 9.5 or so. So you can see this is significantly larger than right here. I mean, that's even narrowed down tighter than, you know, a 510. And if you look at the 810, much closer to the airflow. So this right here is by far my favorite way to vape the Capstone. Very, very nice. You can see right here, it says Capstone right here. Capstone on the back. Very, very cool. Best part of this RDA right here, the deck. This is the Capstone. Now, I know what you're thinking. This looks like a crazy pyramid with no room in it or anything like that. It's just for starters, this is a 24 millimeter RDA. You have dual O-rings. So on the bottom, you will see it says designed by VapeHappy, and then it's VandyVape. And you have a gold-plated squonk pin. It comes squonk ready, installed to squonk. And I highly recommend you just squonk the shit out of this thing. It also has this nice little O-ring right here, which is just gonna keep things tidy. We all know in the world of squonking, it gets a little juicy, gets a little messy. This little O-ring right here though, it just, if you're not fully flush sitting on top of your mod, this keeps it from leaking and making a mess. So very nice touch on that. Now, for the fun part, the pyramid capstone looking system right here. Let me show you how it works. It's one simple Phillips or flat, whatever you want to use. Very simple. You just unscrew it like that. And as you can see, as you unscrew it, each level will start to open up. So one lead would go there, one lead would go there. And you can see this is all spring loaded. So coil installation on here is extremely easy. You can use that coiling tool, but the fact that this pyramid slash capstone design is so wide, you really can just eyeball your coils and clip them short and put them in there and screw them down, because you're not going to have them out. You're going, when you install the coils on here, just put them flush to this, and then you'll see I'll pull them out just a little bit. It's so close already to the edge that your airflow is gonna be right on it. Installation on this is just, it's extremely simple. I really don't know how this could be harder than a normal two-post or three-post design. It's extremely easy to install coils in here, which I will show you. That hole right there, when I have it compressed, you can see the hole right there. That is where it squonks from. Instead of coming from the bottom, filling the deck up, and letting your wicks, the capillary action, bring the e-juice up into your coil, it has a cascading waterfall squonk delivery system, which is actually pretty fucking badass, because the way that this thing distributes the e-juice, it literally lands right on the middle of your coil, exactly where you want it. just like if you were to paint your coil, this paints your coil. It literally squonks directly on all the way across your coil, and then anything left will go down to the bottom. In my humble opinion, this type of squonking action, I feel like, should be the future. Filling up the bottom of your deck and letting it wick up and stuff like that, it takes time. You can get dry hits if you don't wick it right or whatever. With something like this, as soon as you squonk it, your coils are saturated and you're ready to go. So I've just had absolutely a very, very good time with this. I've had no issues with it whatsoever. You'll see juice wells, probably about 5 millimeters or so. If you don't like gold plated decks, they do have a stainless steel deck, but I love gold plated. I think gold plated decks are awesome. So naturally I went with this. Inside of here, there's knurling. There is a rough texture, so it's gonna grab and hold your coil legs in place so they're not gonna slide out when you install them. So very nicely done. Now, this, when I first saw this center block, the first thing I thought, I was like, you know, it's too big, it took up too much space, it doesn't leave you with a lot of room to work with. But after you vape this thing and you get the flavor off of it, you realize that this right here is actually, it's condensing the inside of your chamber. It's making it smaller. And we all know that that leads to more flavor. So the way that the airflow comes in, it comes in lower like that, and it's gonna hit your coil from the bottom, and then it's gonna travel straight up to the top off of this. So there is a reason why this is so large. And if they made this smaller, you know, smaller setup like that, I don't think you would get the flavor that you get from this guy right here. I have a few different RDAs that are using, you know, just the one screw on it like this. This, they executed this better than any other RDA out there, in my opinion. I know there's a couple of RDAs out there that people say this looks like and stuff like that. This performs top notch. Excellent, easy to install. Speaking of installation, since they gave us these beautiful coils and told us all about them, what wattage we should be on, what it's gonna ohm out to and all that good stuff, I think it's time to put a build in and listen to a little bit of music. Now on this one, on this track, if you're a little sensitive to a little colorful language, I suggest hitting mute or putting the earmuffs on.
Hit it.
What do you say when you're too fucked up? And what's your girlfriend say when I smack that butt? What do you say when you run out of drugs? Bustin'
up. LL Cool J needed love like Dirt Nasty needs some drugs like My baby dick needs a tug like right now. So hop that ass in the bathtub. What do I do when I'm too fucked up? Can't keep it up cause the boob job sucks. And what do she do when I whip it out? Close her eyes and open her mouth. I think I need an intervention. Cook a coke, dope, weed, and then prescription. So listen up, little children. Dirt Diggler,
you'll be ill.
I'm feeling kinda drowsy. Don't do drugs without me.
What do you say when you're too fucked up? And what's your girlfriend say when I smack that butt? What do you say when you run out of drugs?
What you gonna do when you get too faded and the date you with wanna get X-rated? Andre Legacy, I stay sedated. Put me in the wheelchair, get me on the plane, bitch. For famous, for being opiated. Up at the club, I fall asleep on the table. Tip the waitress,
pitched the ass, then gave him my number. The kids got panache, lick on my stash. It ain't that easy, living this fast. Forget the past, corn beef and hash. Horny little bitches like to call me their dad. It ain't that bad. Put my dick in their mouth and my nose in their coat bag.
What do you say when you're too fucked up? And what your girlfriend say when I smack that butt? What do you say when you run out of drugs? And baby, what you say when you're...
Okay, so right here, I'm gonna show you how this thing squonks, how it squonks above the coil, and it distributes it across the coil. So here we go. Boom. Money shot right across the entire coil. Top down. This should be the future of squonking right here. Instead of bottom up, top down, perfectly saturates the coil. And when you have the cap on this thing, you're not gonna have to worry. All right, crank it back up.
And I couldn't even tell the difference.
What do you say when you're too fucked up? And what your girlfriend say when I smack that butt? What do you say when you run out of drugs?
And that was an X-rated track along with the VandyVape Capstone by Vape Happy. Let's have a vape. Whew. We're gonna do pros and cons. Start off with the cons, end with the pros, because we always end on a positive note around here. Capstone Vape Happy. My biggest con with this RDA is the AFC on this, not how it works, but the fact that it has a single coil option. I just don't know why you would ever vape this thing single coil. I don't think they needed to put a single coil option on there. I think they could have had some more options with the AFC if they didn't have that big long single coil option on there, and you just could have used one of those plugs that you put on the other side of the deck. Other than that though, that's really my only con. Tolerances on at least, this is by far my favorite cap, the clear plastic one. Getting it on is easy, getting it off is very hard. This thing is, once you put it on there, it's on there. Like, the tolerances are extremely tight. Now, over time, I don't know if this is gonna loosen up or whatever. I mean, I've had this for probably 3 weeks or so, and it's still super tight, and I've been vaping the shit out of it. But those are my only two cons. Pros for Vape Happy Capstone. Pro number one is going to be flavor. This combines big vapor production with flavor. And I think the reason that it's able to produce that much flavor is the fact that center post is so huge. Literally condenses the inside of this chamber. It literally probably cuts the inside of it by at least a third, maybe more. But the flavor on this thing is, it's up, it's in the top tier. It's not the number one flavor dual coil I've ever had, but it's up at the top. Flavor on this thing is, you can't deny it. So flavor, huge, huge pro. Another pro is the squonking system. I think the way that this thing squonks, I don't know why, you know, the first squonker I ever saw that squonked from the top was the 502, which if you haven't seen the review, it's right there. But that squonked from the top and the bottom, and it was a vertical coil. this being horizontal and just squonking from the top, as you saw, it hits the middle of your coil and goes all the way out. It saturates your coil. Every time you squonk this thing, your coil is saturated. If you get a dry hit on this, then you need to go back to squonking 101, learn how to squonk. There are no dry hits. Other thing is, you know, you have this low set airflow. So it acts just like bottom airflow. It comes up underneath the coil and then it rides that pyramid shape right up to the top. The way that this thing is set up, it just vapes. It vapes awesome. Delicious. Also repping some Vapetasia. Vapetasia from the 702 as well, Las Vegas. Killer custard, lemon. One of my favorites. So we got flavor, we have the squonk system, we have the fact that you get multiple caps, you get a badass dock style knurled 810 drip tip, which I won't use on this, but I will definitely use on another dual coil RDA. Very, very, very nice. Huge pro that they actually give you coils and tell you what the coil is, the material, the inner diameter, what it's gonna ohm out to, all that stuff. It sounds so simple, but I would say 10% of the RDAs that I get that come with coils gives you all the information. Most of the time it's just coils and it's like you don't know what the hell it is. Especially if you're running stuff on mech mods and stuff like that, you kind of want to know what the hell material you have. It's just nice that they told us, you know, this is nichrome 80. It's, I think, a 6 wrap or a 5 wrap, 3 millimeter inner diameter. What it ohms out to, it says 0.28 on there. I think that's single coil because this thing came in like around 0.17. 0.15 to 0.17 with the duals. Got it on the VandyVape Pulse 80 watt at 75 watts. And this thing is just, the vapor production is huge, but it does not sacrifice flavor whatsoever. Quiet, quiet, very, very quiet airflow, listen. Another pro. For those of you that don't like whistling, you don't like the whistle, you don't like the screechy or any of that shit, I've only put 3 builds in here. None of them have whistled whatsoever. The coil installation on this with this system is so easy. You don't need the coily tool at all. Because this thing is so wide, you saw I just clipped mine down pretty short. And you just hold it directly against this center pyramid as you screw it down. And then you just pull the coils back slightly on each side. There just needs to be a little tiny gap for the rest of the juice to go down. You can't, there's no room to have a coil pulled all the way out. So it makes the installation actually easier because you're just pushing both coils all the way in, tighten it down, and then bending them back. Installation, for me, this is a very, very good RDA for someone who's just getting into rebuildables. I think that this thing is, I mean, I've heard people say that it's hard to put coils in because there's not a lot of room, but you don't need any room. You're not, your coils aren't sitting out like that. I mean, you're literally right up against that pyramid and you just peel it out just a tiny bit. The way that the airflow lines up, I could pull these coils up just a tad, but right now, I mean, this is hitting the bottom half of the coil, and it's just coming right up, so it's getting the killer flavor. Cautionary note, if you are gonna run anything clear, this goes with anything, don't run dark juices, because it just looks nasty, you know. Typically, a clear juice looks good. Killer custard has kind of got a little yellow tint to it. When you put like brown e-juice in here and stuff like that, and you have the clear cap on, it looks like doo-doo. So just make sure that you're vaping something. If you're gonna use the clear cap, I suggest sticking to clear or lighter color e-liquids just so it doesn't look like you're vaping poo. Spring too, the spring on this. Very, very, very nice. I mean, when you unscrew it, it's very springy. Put it in, goes right back down. Super easy. They give you extra spring just in case your Tommy torque wrench and you break it or you do whatever. Overall, I am thoroughly impressed with this RDA. I really don't vape a ton of dual coils. Single coil restrictive is more my speed just because I'm a flavor chaser, I'm not a cloud chaser. But that's the thing about this RDA that impressed me so much is the flavor. I've watched a couple of reviews and I haven't heard anyone say that anything bad about the flavor on this. Price on this, you're gonna be looking at between 35 or 30, I think maybe 38. I think 38 is what Vape Happy has it for. I'm gonna leave the link description below. Before I forget, I wanna say thank you very much to Vape Happy, to Vape Malone, Aaron, Mike, and the lady that works there. I forget your name, I'm sorry. I know I see you all the time, but you guys are all fucking awesome, and I appreciate you giving me the capstone to review. I'm sure I'll see you guys soon. I always drop by to get my cotton and e-juice and stuff like that. So thank you very much, Vape Happy. Vape Malone too, that's kind of a fucking badass name. I mean, do I think I need to change my name? No? Marjorie said no, so no, okay. But Vape Malone, you got a cool name. So that's a pro too, pro on that. That's it, that's all I have. That's all I have on the capstone. Thank you all so much for watching, for leaving comments, for subscribing, for all the feedback, all that stuff. I don't know what's going on out there in the world. I do know that it's summertime, so I hope you're having fun doing something, staying cool. If you live in Las Vegas, do not go outside because it is like hot as balls out. Just don't do it. Just stay inside with the AC. That being said, right here with my Capstone RDA, sweating like crazy in the Las Vegas desert, it's still all love. So thank you all so much, and I'll catch you on the next one.
Vape Malone, what up?